The war in Ukraine has shown that artillery remains the king of the battle. Both sides in the conflict rely heavily on long-range fire to inflict casualties and deny territory to the enemy. The M777-155mm howitzer has bolstered the long-range fire capabilities of the Ukrainian military. But for many, it is the formidable M109 Paladin self-propelled howitzer that the Ukrainian military needs the most. The new generation Paladin M109A7 artillery system, manufactured by BAE Systems, is an upgrade of the battle-tested Paladin M109A6 artillery system. The improved artillery system provides key fire support during a variety of combat missions in a variety of conditions, which greatly increases their effectiveness. Currently, the 155mm M109 Paladin self-propelled artillery is the latest weapon of this type in the US Army. This means that Ukrainian artillerymen received state-of-the-art weapons, not old decommissioned SPH. History of creation and development of M109 Paladin. M109A7 is a new artillery system for the US Army. It is an upgraded version of M109A6. Previously, this system was known as M109A6 PIM or Paladin Integrated Management. The first prototype was introduced in 2007. Unofficially, the M109A7 is still called Paladin. The prototypes of M109A7 have passed state tests, and in 2013 this artillery system was approved for mass production. A contract has been signed with BAE Systems to upgrade the first M109A6 systems to the M109A7 standard. The US Army planned to obtain a total of 580 M109A7 howitzers and as many accompanying armored ammunition carriers. After modernization, these self-propelled artillery systems are expected to last until 2050. The new M109A7 SPH uses some technology that was originally developed for the XM2001 Crusader and XM1203 NLOSC self-propelled howitzers. M109A7 Paladin design and features. Some civilians call this self-propelled unit a tank because it is a mechanized tracked vehicle. But do not make this mistake, because we are dealing with a mobile field artillery gun with a long barrel. The Paladin Integrated Management, PIM, upgrade program includes upgrades to the hull, turret, engine, and suspension systems for greater reliability, survivability, and efficiency compared to the M109A6 artillery system. The upgraded system is able to provide consistent fire support in all weather conditions. The gun is equipped with a digital fire control system and an advanced charging system, and is mounted on a chassis with suspension elements and transmission from M2 Bradley IFV. The tower can rotate 360 degrees. The M109A7 has a total length of 9.7 meters, a width of 3.9 meters, a height of 3.7 meters, and a maximum gross weight of 35,380 kilograms. The upgraded unit received a digital backbone architecture and a built-in digital fire control system, a navigation system and a computer with comprehensive diagnostic programs. The new artillery system can select and occupy firing positions, as well as automatically unlock and direct the gun while moving. Armament of M109 Paladin. This artillery system is equipped with the same 155mm 39-lira howitzer as the previous M109A6. However, now the SPH is equipped with a new automated loader. That is, the Paladin M109A7 artillery system is armed with a 155mm M284 cannon with an M182A1 cannon installation and automatic loading. It can fire at a steady rate of 1 shot per minute, while the maximum rate of fire is 4 shots per minute. The maximum range of standard projectiles is 24 kilometers and 30 kilometers for jet projectiles. The M109A7 can also fire M982 Excalibur high-precision guided projectiles with a maximum range of up to 40 kilometers. That is, the Paladin self-propelled howitzer can use not only standard, but also high-precision ammunition, including Excalibur, and is equipped with a precision guidance system. The modernized artillery system is equipped with an automatic fire control system with an integrated navigation and inertial positioning system. It is also equipped with a muzzle reference system. Upon arrival at the firing position, the system independently determines the location of the SPH, processes information about the target and provides data for shooting. M109A7 Paladin has a short response and relocation time. This allows you to start moving immediately after the shot, which helps avoiding enemy counter-battery fire. Once the M109A7 Paladin moves to a new position, it will be ready to fire again within 60 seconds. Such mobility ensures significant firepower of the axe. Defense features of M109 Paladin. The armor of this self-propelled howitzer provides protection from small arms fire and fragments of artillery shells. It can be equipped with an additional set of armor, as well as a set of armor of the highest level of protection. The turret is equipped with a Kevlar lining, which provides protection against shrapnel and high explosive shells. Like all modern axe, the M109A7 Paladin is equipped with NBC protection system, gunner protection kit, GPK, and automatic fire extinguishing system, AFES. Engine and mobility of M109 Paladin. Like its predecessor, the 155mm M109A7 Paladin self-propelled howitzer is equipped with a 600 horsepower Cummins engine from the standard Bradley combat vehicle. However, the transition to an electric turret drive involved a significant overhaul of the machine's power system. 600 horsepower engine provides various onboard systems with a direct current of 70 kilowatts and a voltage of 600 volts 28 volts. The torsion suspension of M109A7 on both sides consists of 7 double rubber support wheels with a leading sprocket at the front and a tension wheel at the rear. There are no support rollers. The modularity of the power supply system means that if any of the internal motors fail, it can be replaced in the field in less than 15 minutes. Specifically, this means that the howitzer crew can cope with the problem and continue to perform the combat mission instead of going to the rear for repairs. The new chassis is made and assembled from Bradley M2-M3 components. Although this has led to the increase of the overall weight by about 5%, the combined effect of using a new chassis and more reliable drive components allows the Paladin PIM to work with heavier loads than its current maximum gross weight of around 39 t 35.4 t. The M109 has a fuel tank capacity of 545 liters and a ground clearance of 0.4 meters. The SPH can cross the ford at a maximum depth of 1.05 meters and cross trenches with a depth of 1.8 meters. The inclination and lateral slopes of the vehicle are 60% and 40% respectively. The speed the road is 61 kilometers per hour and the range is 322 kilometers. The crew of M109A7 Paladin consists of 4 to 6 people, commander, driver, gunner, gunner's assistant, 2 loaders, depending on the tasks. The driver's seat is located in the front of the hull to the left of the engine, and the gunner is located on the left side of the turret. The commander's seat, located in the turret on the right, is equipped with a periscope surveillance device, a rotating turret mount for a large caliber machine gun, and a hatch. M109 Paladin howitzers for Ukraine. The Ukrainian military has asked for and received artillery pieces from the US and NATO. The Pentagon is sending 90 M777 155mm howitzers to Ukraine, while Canada and Australia are sending additional howitzers of the same type. Moreover, the United Kingdom is sending 12 AS-90 155mm armored self-propelled artillery pieces, France is contributing 12 Caesar 155mm trucked self-propelled howitzers, and the Netherlands, Belgium, and Italy have agreed to send their Panzerhaubitz 2000 SP 155mm self-propelled howitzers, or M109 Paladins, when the countries have them. The US military is the largest user of the M109 Paladin. So it is natural to wonder whether the Pentagon will be adding the self-propelled howitzer in any future shipments of military aid to Ukraine. Kirby had been asked why the US isn't sending any M109 Paladin howitzers to Ukraine. And it's not just the United States. Other nations are providing systems as well. So, I'm not going to get inside the conversations we're having with the Ukrainians privately about their needs. But I think the proof is in what we're announcing every day about how seriously we're taking their requirements, the Pentagon press secretary added. Another senior U.S. official added that the Pentagon talks constantly with the Ukrainian military about its needs. He recognized that long-range fires are probably the most important weapon system in the war right now, suggesting that the U.S. military might be sending additional artillery pieces to Ukraine should the need or want arise.